Good growth. The events of 2020, we learned that grief comes in many forms. A job loss, a relationship, homes, businesses, and just life as we knew it. As a society came to a screeching halt, over 330 million people learned what it felt like to be isolated, to be lonely, working and homeschooling, and we learned what it felt like to lose loved ones. For the first time in our generation, we were forced with an uncertainty. Since the beginning of the pandemic, I myself have begun learning how to grow in such an uncertain time. I've poured into businesses, I've sown seeds into ministry, I have began to grow plants. I have 12 different species of plants. And I know that some of you will say, well, I don't have a green thumb. Put your thumb up, look at it real close. None of us have green thumbs, but all of us have the opportunity to slow down and pay attention to life itself. And that's what my plants have done for me. It has encouraged me to slow down and pay attention. Out of the 12 plants, about 10 of them were given to me by other people. And that's what makes them very special to me. One of the things that makes them special and what made me feel encouraged to make sure that I kept them alive. Out of the 12 different species of plants, I'm going to actually talk to you today about three of them. The three that I chose is one, the peace lily. As you can see with my peace lily, it loves sunlight and it's in a big old pot that I have to keep filled with water in order for it to thrive. As you can see, some of the leaves are standing up really tall and reaching for the sky. And then some of them are leaning downward with a droop. Those different positions in the plant tell me what the plant may be going through. It maybe needs some water. Maybe it needs some more sunlight. Maybe it needs some nourishment or something. I chose this peace lily out of my 12 plants because this is the plant that is often given to families that are grieving lost loved ones. It's an easygoing plant. It does not require much to grow. It just requires some time and attention. And I believe that God has given us this plant to slow us down and to actually take a good perspective on life and how to live it, how to nourish it, the things that we need in order to thrive. And so this is my plant. I call it Mr. Paul. I've given it a name. And Mr. Paul has been with me for about 3 years. Now, Mr. Paul probably won't live to be more than about maybe 5 or 6 years old. And that's something that I have to come to terms with as well, especially when once in a while I come and there's a yellow leaf on Mr. Paul. What do I do when I'm working so hard and now there's a yellow leaf and it looks like it's fading away? It's just a reminder that that's what life does. Pieces of us just fade away, things that just don't live. They don't move on into the next life with us. The second plant that I would like to share with you is what I call my Rex begonia. This is one of my favorites. This plant is an exotic plant. It has black tiger stripes on it. And ladies and gentlemen, I killed two of them before I was able to grow that flourishing plant that you're looking at right there. I have to say it was pre-pandemic when I was attempting to grow that plant. And this is one of those plants, it asks for attention. If I turn it around to the back, it leans towards the sun. If I turn it back the other way, it goes back the other way. It is a living species. It is really cool. But with this one, being that I lost two of them, it was tough to jump back in there and start a third one. Starting with the third one, I'm looking at this thing so closely on like, how do I grow this plant? And because it was given to me three times, it was tough to the thought that I could fail a third time. But now during the pandemic, I was able to sit back and I was able to pay attention to what this plant was asking for, what it was needing and things like that. With this Rex begonia, it's very dear to me because the very one you're looking at It got down to three leaves. It got down to three leaves, and I thought I was going to lose it again. But again, like I said, you sit back and you relax, pay attention. And I began to learn more about the plant's needs. And now this plant is just reaching out towards the world. It's reaching up towards the sun like I've never seen before, thriving. And I take that plant and I apply it to the life of myself, and I apply it to other people's lives, that if we are nourished properly, if we have the proper things that we need, that we will continue to flourish. Even if we got down to our lowest, which is those three leaves, we still have the opportunity to flourish. And if we're not careful, we can be like my third plant. The third plant that I want to show you is called a Fittonia. Now I'm going to show you, this is what my Fittonia looks like when it has not been well nourished. It doesn't have the water that it's asking for. It's a very dramatic plant. It's very dramatic. This plant has to be watered literally every 7 days. From the seventh day, if I do not water that plant, I can walk in and it looks just like this. It looks like it's dying. It looks like it's tired. It looks like it has not had any kind of attention. And I promise you that this plant has had some water. It has had the nutrients that it needs. But at this point, 7 days later, it's like, I need more. I need more. So, of course, I have to pay more attention to it. Literally, I can water this plant and an hour later, it will look like this. 1 hour later, it's standing up as if nothing ever happened. It requires a misting every few hours. It requires fertilizer. It requires attention, time and attention more than others. And some of us are going through that same notion. We just need some time. We need some attention, and we need to nourish ourselves. Nourishing ourselves could be finding new hobbies, such as mine with the plants. It can be singing, it can be writing, you know. We just got to add to ourselves. We have to continue to add on to ourselves, or we'll be like the earth plant, down one day, stretching up the next day. And we can be like the Rex begonia, where we would just require too much. We just require for the sunlight so we can reach for it. We require a lot of watering, and we can be like the peace lily where we're calm and we don't require much. So those are the three plants that I wanted to bring up that I thought kind of met with all of us in our needs and our different forms of grieving. It's time to find ways, if we need to adjust the light, or if we need to adjust the watering schedule, or we just need to adjust things in our lives in order to clear our minds and open our hearts so that we can begin thriving again, and we don't have to look like the Fittonia every day. We don't have to be like the begonia the Rex begonia, where we got down to three leaves and then just don't know what to do. We don't know if tomorrow is going to come or whatnot. We don't have to be there. It's time to open up your hearts, your minds, your spirits for growth and to thrive with an intention. I am reminded by my favorite scripture, which is John 15:5. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. So like I said, if you're feeling droopy today, if you're feeling down, if you're feeling like you're not growing, adjust the light. Adjust your watering, adjust your nutrients, adjust your life. So until you feel that yourself is coming back, the you that you're used to is coming back and growing and thriving. If you are flourishing, if you are flourishing in life, then you don't have to do anything but continue doing what you do. My name is Tiffany DeWalt, life coach with Life on Purpose. And I pray good growth and nutrients and thriving for your life today. You can do this thing called life. Let's get it together.